हेलो एवरीवन, यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 623 एंड टुडेस टॉपिक ऑफ माय लेक्चर इज द हेल्थ बेनिफिट्स ऑफ सिनेमन बार्क। इन इंडियन लैंग्वेज वी कॉल इट दालचीनी। इज अ वेरी वेरी डिलीशियस एंड मेडिसिनल स्पाइस थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड। It is available in powder form and it is rich in volatile. 75% of cinnamon bark contains cinnamic aldehyde and rest of the 25% they are other terpene like hydrocarbon terpene, pinene, myrcene and ugolith, tannin and mucilage. So they are the main medicinal compounds and anti-inflammatory as well as antioxidant properties mainly goes to cinnamic aldehyde. This cinnamic aldehyde is actually the main constituent which makes dalchini, that is cinnamon bark, very very important. And let me go through the history. We have thousands of years history of using this cinnamon bark in Indian subcontinent, and it played very important role during Spanish flu in 1919 when millions of the people they died out of Spanish influenza. And they noticed that those people who were taking cinnamon bark, dalchini tea and in stew and food preparation, it was added, they were protected from that influenza. It is a given. So at that time there was no vaccine, no any other medicine. So it is reported that cinnamon bark, dalchini bark played very important role, and it is very important antiviral, and also it boosts our immune system, and it is antifungal, it will protect our teeth from decay. And latest research shows that cinnamon bark powder which contains that is cinnamic aldehyde is very much effective to neutralize HIV virus. So it is very powerful antiviral medicine. Also cinnamon bark is powerful antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, and that's why it is good for our cardiovascular health. It protects our heart, and also it can improve our blood circulation. So this, it is also very good anti-clotting. So it has, it is packed with lot of medicinal properties, and I have given here the structure. This is your actually cinnamic aldehyde, which is having one aromatic ring with aldehyde group here, and your cinnamon bark, the botanical name is cinnamonum Zinesium, and it belongs to family Lauraceae. So this cinnamon bark contains 75% of cinnamic aldehyde, and it is also called cinnamon aldehyde, and it contains 10% eunuol. This is all volatile oil. Then myrcene is hydrocarbon terpene, osimine, pinene and phenandrine. These are all volatile terpene oil, and this is all present in your cinnamon bark. And let me tell you, cinnamon barks are of two types. One is called Ceylon cinnamon bark, other one is called Cassia cinnamon bark. And cinnamon barks, there are two types. One is little bit thick and one is very thin. So you should not have any confusion because of volume. There's something is very thick, so it means it will be very rich source of those volatile oil. No, the thinner one is the best, and there the percentage of your cinnamic aldehyde is more as compared to thick one. So the thin one and thin bark dalchini is of high quality, that is called Ceylon dalchini or cinnamon bark. Actually Ceylon name come from Sri Lanka, is from there I think lot of production is coming. And the second one is cassia cinnamon bark, that is thick one. So the Ceylon cinnamon bark is the best one. It is how many minutes? So here, in continuation, the cinnamon bark, that is dalchini in Indian name. The botanical name is Cinnamonum zileaceum, and it belongs to family Lauraceae. Number one, this is very rich in volatile oil, and it contains 70% cinnamic aldehyde, that is also known as cinnamaldehyde, and 10% eugenol is also type of terpene. They are all mixture of volatile oil, that is terpene. And mixture of terpenes like hydrocarbon terpene, and I have given all these structures. Hydrocarbon terpene means myrcene, and then pinene, all those are there. Then phenylrene and chlorophylline, and rest are mucilage, calcium oxalate and starch. It has very good taste. Actually cinnamon bark powder, sometimes it is adulterated and lot of manipulation is there. So in order to know whether it is original or not, just take maybe little amount of powder, put in ethyl alcohol and filter it, and that ethyl alcohol in that one, if you put just few drop of alcoholic ferric chloride solution, it will change into pale green color, and that pale green color shows the presence of cinnamic aldehyde. And if cinnamic aldehyde is there, it means it is 100% pure cinnamon bark powder. So that is the test. One drop of oil in 5 ml of ethyl alcohol, plus add ferric chloride solution, and then pale green color confirms cinnamic aldehyde. Number three, the volatile oil can reduce muscle spasms and can increase blood flow. It is a very good for our muscle spasm also. So once we are regularly taking cinnamon either as a spice in food or in tea, it can have two very important benefits. One, it will help in muscle spasm, and also it will increase the blood flow. And once blood flow is increased, means oxygen is quickly reaching to all the organs, and your health will be okay. It is available in powder form, is highly delicious. The medicinal properties are known since thousands of years ago, and there are two types of cinnamon I have already told you. One is called Ceylon cinnamon bark, and other one is called, that is cassia cinnamon bark. And the one which is thin, of very good quality, they are rich in actually cinnamic aldehyde, or we can call it cinnamaldehyde. So the thin one is the best, that is Ceylon one. And the one which is thick, it is high in volume, but it is not high in volatile oil. That is not of good quality. So go for thin bark, cinnamon, not the thick one. Number four, it is loaded with antioxidants and anti-inflammatory compounds. So once you are taking it, it means you are pumping lot of anti-inflammatory and antioxidant compounds in your body, and these two are responsible of boosting your immune system. And once your immune system is strong, you can fight the pathogens like bacteria, virus, as well as fungus. And it is very good antifungal, that's why it protects your decay of teeth. And it is very good anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, that's why it is very good for our cardiovascular health. And also it is anti-cancerous, and that may help in heart disease, may reduce LDL, that is low density lipoprotein, that is bad triglyceride, bad cholesterol. And then it is good for brain cells, and it can also help to reduce the chances of either Alzheimer's or Parkinson. Alzheimer's means it is a long-term memory loss dementia, means where your brain cells are degenerated. So it can also help to regenerate your neuro cells, brain cells. So it is good for our neuro health also, and may protect against cancer. It can fight viral, bacteria and fungal disease. It helps to fight tooth decay. And also, if you have the bad breath, you take cinnamon, there will not be bad breath. And also, cinnamon bark can fight HIV virus. And also the latest research shows that this pale yellow color, that is a cinnamic aldehyde isolated from cinnamon bark, that is dalcini bark, is very good for our tongue backside bacteria. What if you take one drop, it will clear all the bacteria what they are settled at the back of our tongue. And also this cinnamic aldehyde is a very good anti-clotting agent also. So if you are taking cinnamon bark powder in as a spice or in tea, it is very good. It will not allow the blood clotting. So here with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture. And to boost your immune system nowadays, it's better to add in your food. I know that in Indian subcontinent, there is no curry or stew, korma without cinnamon powder. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.